guys, and welcome back to my channel. So to start off with, you just want to draw a spiral on your rock. And this does work better with a round rock, but you could use whatever shape you wanted. But I would follow the contour of the surface of whatever you're using. So for me, a round rock, so I just made a spiral. And I'm using Liquitex, the fluorescent pink. I really love this color for blending in with like yellows and blues. And you want to paint your design. I'm using kind of a slashing motion with my paintbrush. You want it to be loose with jagged edges. I'm sorry, my bird's talking in the background. Hopefully she's not too distracting. And as you work your way out from the middle, you want to widen your line a little bit. So it's going to grow in thickness as I go around the rock. And if you do use the fluorescent pink, it is pretty transparent. So you'll have to go over this in a couple of layers to cover the pencil line. And you want to make sure to wrap your paint around the edge of your rock to give it a finished edge. So now I'm just going over it with a second coat. And this first color, you may not know exactly how wide you want to make your stripe, because we're going to add yellow, a stripe of yellow, and a stripe of blue. And so, you know, you want to make sure that you leave enough white area there for those other two colors. But you can extend it out. So don't worry too much if you don't get your line thick enough. So now I'm taking, this is primary blue, and I'm just going to kind of follow the same line as the pink, but I'm not overlapping my colors yet. I'll do that in a later step. And this will probably take two coats of paint if you use the primary blue by Liquitex Basics. Their basic line is more translucent than if you use like their soft body or their heavy body paints. But I do a lot of glazing in my other painting tutorials. You know that I use a lot of glazes. And translucent paints work a lot better than a heavy body, which is a more opaque paint. Plus, the basic line is a little less expensive. So I really like the Liquitex Basics. And you see how it kind of, adding the blue kind of thinned out my pink line. That's why I'm going to go back over and extend the pink line into the blue. And that's going to create that purple, and it's going to make the pink line look a little wider. But I'm going to do that in a future step. First, I'm going to add my yellow. I'm not real sure which yellow this is. I'll have to look it up and post. I'll have it posted down below in the description, everything I'm using here. I'm using my Holotap paintbrush for this step. Now the yellow I am allowing to go over into the pink a little bit. This is the first one where I'm starting to overlap the paint colors. But when we're all said and done, all of the paints are going to overlap each other to create the purple and the green color that's in there. And that, you know, to build that tie-dyed effect. And I will straighten out my blue curve a little bit. It's kind of flat on that one side. I do go back in and fix that a little bit later on. So this rock is really forgiving. You could also, instead of doing the swirl, you could just start in the middle and do more of like a starburst. You could do whatever design you wanted. I just went with the swirl. This would be cute in a starburst, or if you used a different shape rock, you could, you know, just following the contour of the rock would be cute also. So now I'm going back with my blue and kind of straightening out. I'm focusing more on the line between the blue and the yellow, and also adding another layer of paint to any of the kind of thin areas where the paint doesn't feel like it covers very well. And I just want a very thin line of the green, where it's making the green color. I don't want the green to be as thick as the primary colors were. So now I'm taking my pink, and I'm going to blend the pink, pull it down into the blue. And that's going to help make a thin line of purple, and it's going to help extend that pink line out just a little bit, so it doesn't look quite so thin. Because I lost a lot of the jagged effect also when I put in the blue, because the blue's so much darker than the, it was hard to say for some reason, so much darker than the pink. And just make sure your edges are painted well. So now that my rock is painted and it's dried, I'm mixing up some epoxy. I'm using the stone coat. And I always start with part B first because it's a thinner viscosity. And then I add part A to that. If you do the thin part first and then the thick part second, you'll get a better blend. It'll blend better, and therefore you have a better chance of not getting sticky spots in your resin. If you ever get sticky spots in your resin, it's because you either didn't mix equal parts, or you didn't mix it well. And I've had that happen to me, and it's kind of a nightmare to deal with. So now that I have my epoxy all mixed up, you want to put your rock on something that the epoxy won't stick to. So I'm using butcher block paper with the shiny side up, and then I have a silicone mat underneath it to raise it up just a little bit so that I can get around the edges without creating a pool around my rock. And I'm taking just a very thin coat of epoxy and just kind of smearing it on there, but you want it very thin. You don't want it to run over the sides of your rock. And now I'm putting some catch paper down. Again, this is butcher block paper, and I'm using Promises. This is Promises Glitter by Glitter and Grand. I'll have a link to them also below in the description. And I'm just pouring a good coat. Now, if you like the rock prior to the glitter, then you could just epoxy and be done. I wanted to see what the glitter would look like. A lot of my rocks here lately are just kind of experiments on doing something a little different with glitter and epoxy. And for me, I get bored real easy, so just painting rocks gets kind of boring. So that's why here lately I've been using a lot of glitter. I've also been doing tumblers, and so I get a lot of my inspiration from my tumbler designs for my rocks. It's like, can I turn this tumbler design into a rock? And, you know, let's see how that'll work. So a lot of this is just experimenting. So I actually, at first, I was a little hesitant on whether I liked the glitter, because you kind of lose a little of the tie-dyed effect. So if you wanted to just stop at the epoxy, it's going to look beautiful. If you do like the glitter, and the glitter's grown on me, so I do like it now. When I first saw it, I was like, oh, I was disappointed. But now I really do like it. So either way, you know, whatever floats your boat. So now I've gone in and I worked up the design for my text. And I did that on the computer, and then I created a traceable file for it. And then transferred it over to my rock using Sorel transfer paper, which sticks really well to epoxy. Sometimes, like, you can't really write on epoxy very easily, like with a charcoal pencil or anything. So I used this Sorel transfer paper to get the design over onto the rock. And now I'm just going in and just tracing out the design. I will have the traceable file for the Radiate Good Vibes over on my private Facebook group, which is free to join, and all of my traceable files are located over there, and they're free to everybody. You just have to join the group to have access to those. There are some of my older tutorials where those files aren't loaded, but I do have them available. If you can't find one, just message me and let me know, and I'll get it loaded for you. I used to put them over on my Patreon page, and I don't do Patreon anymore because I just don't have time. So now I'm trying to provide them for free over on my private Facebook group, but they're not all loaded over there, so again, you can just message me if you can't find one, and I'll get it loaded for you. For the lettering, I'm using the Titanium White by Liquitex Basics. I'm also using a disposable eyeliner brush that I got off of Amazon. I'll link that in the description below as well. They work really well for fine lines. And I think I got like 100 in a pack, and they're real cheap. And the other thing I forgot to mention is you may need to do 2 coats of epoxy before you add your text. It was something I meant to tell you back when we were in the epoxy stage. But you don't want to start doing the lettering until your rock is completely smooth. And the glitter will sometimes create a texture. So definitely epoxy it twice. So here's the finished results. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one.